A great part of the great outdoors, North Country Outdoors Radio.
In the fish house with, we're going to call him Grandpa Jimmy Dresch. Now, hard to call him Grandpa. I think I'm 2 years older than you, Jimmy.
Yeah, I'm a grandpa to somebody.
Yeah, we've got a great new thing. First fish, coming with 828, and I got to do something here. I got to turn this down. I'm losing this fish, all right? I'm going to watch what's going on. There we go, I got him. So this fish, this might keep. Still got a bunch of ice leaving in my hole. Here comes the fish, coming up into the hole. Okay, now I'm going to step on this trap below. Look at this walleye. Now, and he flew off the hook. Perfect, there he is. Still there. All I got to do is keep my foot on the trap. I can take my time, get down here and grab this fish though. It's not going to be a mad dash dive to get down there and get him. Come on, buddy. Here we go. Whoop. All right, that's the first time I've done that. So, heck, a nice walleye. It is a 16-inch walleye, my first fish of the day. Those fish that you catch and get off in the hole, and you're old like me, you're trying to get on your hands and knees and dig that one out. Jimmy, take that ice hole trap out. Just pull that up out of the water. Let's take a look at it. All right, now, obviously this sits above. Goes down, this is a flipper. Now what happened? You got a fish that's up in the hole. As soon as he gets up in the hole, Jimmy, what? You step on that thing. And look what happens. Simple enough. Here it is. There you go. Boy, it's a nice one. It's another nice one. Let's see if we can get this one up without losing this fish. I'll get him up into this hole. Come on around the corner, buddy. Yeah. All right. It's a nice auger. I've got him fish trapped. So if he does get off, this is a 15-inch auger right here. Well, okay, 14.5-inch auger. And this lays tight enough against the side of the hole. If you notice my holes, I've drilled them close to the edge. All my holes are close to the edge here. And here's one that's down in the hole. You can see how that sits. Now, the next we're shooting videos, we're going to be using these for a while so you can see how cool they are. He bit it, and I got him. There's another keeper. Okay, I've got my hole. Don't lose this fish. Come on. Not a giant, but it's a guy. Every fish I've caught here today has been pretty good. But give them to watch this. Fish trap. There's fish up the hole. I stamped on that, and now he can't get away. And this is at least a 16-inch walleye. But look at that. See that flipper down there? Let go. Boom. It trips back up and is gone. Tell me, how do people, if they figure they got to get one of these, how do they get a hold of you, and how does it work?
Well, the website is grandpajimmy.com.
Hit it. Got it. Got it. Got it. Well, oh yeah. You saw that, right? That's what it used to be. I didn't care about that one. Anyway, it didn't turn out to be as, that one they kept. And I sure could have stepped on that fish trap and got that one. But that's exactly what the fish trap saves you from.
They come with an extension on. Now, because we're in the wheelhouse, fishing with Kurt here, the legend of Lake of the Woods, we've got an extension on because we're up above the ice a little higher.
This has got holes in it, all right? So you could move this whole thing up. If the ice is not very deep, you can make it shallower. You don't want this hanging down below the bottom of the hole. You want this at the bottom or just above the bottom of the hole, right?
Yeah.
So when that swings that, close that gate on. So this moves it up. Heck, you've got, so looks like a foot or so you could deal with. Yeah.
So if you're sitting in a portable fish house, maybe you're sitting on a bucket outside or something, you can use it with the tip up. There's a 12-inch extension that comes out and you can bring it up. So,
and to make all these adjustments, you need a Phillips screwdriver. I've done it a couple times now, and it's easy to put together. Tough as nails. You could take a hammer to this thing, right?
It's galvanized steel, so yep. It won't rust and it'll last forever.
Got him! I got him! Jesus, a nice fish! Come on. I knew it was a nice fish. I got my fish trapped on this hole too. All right, here we go. Don't get away, don't get away. Every time I turn that camera a little bit, get out of there. Get out of there. He's in the hole, fish traps down on him. Look at this guy. Look at this one. This fish was down there for a long time messing with me. Oh, over here. Hey, eyes over here, pal. He's leaving. All right, this one is 17 and a half incher.
We mounted on a solid oak board.
Oh, yeah.
So these are solid oak. They're cut and stained. They're beautiful. You just lock it on your fish trap and you're ready to go. This is for an 8-inch hole. We also make one for a 10-inch hole.
Okay,
that's good. So if
you got
your two auger sizes, so.
And they figure he's using oak for this. That shows you the whole thing is overbuilt. Because obviously you could have cheapened up on this thing a little bit, but that's a good quality thing. It's stained, it'll last forever, and so will your fish trap.
Yep, solid galvanized steel. So they're pretty much indestructible.
Here's a big fish. Here's a big fish. Look at him go. Wow. 11:15. I think this is a walleye too. This is super duper. I get to use my fish trap on a big one. Oh, look here. Oh, it's a pike. Okay, now even with that big fish, now he's stuck. See? Earlier, this is a 26-incher. It's a good keeper pike. If you want to keep pike on Lake of the Woods.
It operates on gravity, which is the key to the whole deal. Because when you put it,
yeah,
when you close it,
yeah,
it closes by itself. You don't need any rods or strings or springs or anything. So,
all right. The web address is again what now?
GrandpaJimmy.com.
Very simple. If you've ever lost a fish in the hole, I know you're thinking, well, I should try one of those. That's how you can do it.
A great part of the great outdoors. North Country Outdoors Radio.